Hi everyone, welcome to Think Smart Home. Today we are going to install Node-RED on Home Assistant, and this will be followed by a brief introduction of some features of Node-RED. Before we go to the tutorial, let's see what is Node-RED. So Node-RED is a very powerful web browser based tool for building Internet of Things applications. Node-RED is developed with a focus on simplifying the wiring of code blocks to carry out some tasks. Now these code blocks which we are talking here, they are called nodes within the Node-RED. There are tons of nodes available which come pre-installed with Node-RED for Home Assistant, but we can also add more nodes using palettes. We'll talk more about palettes later in this video. Now what do you need for this tutorial? Of course, a working installation of Home Assistant, and then we will need to install Node-RED from addon store, and then there is an optional step if you really want to control these automation or nodes from Home Assistant dashboard directly, you can use Node-RED companion integration. I personally don't use this companion integration because in some cases it didn't work very well for me, so I use switches within the Node-RED to enable or disable automation from the dashboard directly. Let me know in the comments below if you are interested to see how I am controlling my automations. Alright, so let's get started. To install Node-RED, go to addon store and search for Node-RED and install it. It might take some time to download and install the addon. While this is happening, please give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. And hit the bell icon to get notified when I add a new video about smart home automations. Okay, now the installation is complete, so let's start the add-on. Then you can go ahead and install Node-RED companion integration from Hex. If you haven't installed Hex already, I have created a step-by-step video on how to do that. I'll leave the link to that video on top right corner of this video or also down in the description below. Now under Hex, let's search for Node-RED and download it. Then under settings, go to device and services and click on add integration and search for Node-RED. And then from here you can add it to your Home Assistant. There will be no entities present under this integration because we haven't created any flows or any node yet in Node-RED. Since I don't have lots of devices in my test Home Assistant solution, so I'll take you over to my production Home Assistant server to run through the basics of Node-RED and show you some examples over there. I personally prefer Node-RED over native Home Assistant automation because I can see almost the whole flow on one screen and can follow it while it is running, and that helps me troubleshoot any issues if they are. Now you can see I have already created flow based on some areas or applications. Alright, I'll create a new blank flow by clicking the plus icon. I'll give you the walkthrough of the GUI first. You can hide the right hand side menu bar to increase your workspace area. On the left side, you'll see all the nodes. Please be advised, if you have just installed Node-RED and the nodes on your installation might be different to what you can see on my Home Assistant. This is because I have added more nodes. I'll show you later how you can add nodes to your Node-RED installation. On the right side, you can see these tabs. The first one is Info. Here you can search through the flows for any specific node. Let's say if I search for shutters, I can go straight to the flow or that node by clicking on the search icon. This is very handy when you have a complex and crowded flows. Then we have a tab for help. Here you can read the help box for any node which is selected within the flow. This will help you configuring the nodes in case you are facing any issues. Then we have debug tab, which will show any error on your flow and the output messages when you use debug nodes. Debug node is one of the most important nodes. It will help you finding errors or configuration mistakes within the nodes and makes troubleshooting easier. There are a few other tabs which I will not be covering as a part of this video. Now back to the nodes on the left hand side. You can simply drag a node you want to use from the left side into the flow. For this example, I'll drag most commonly used node called state chain node. And I'll double click on this node to edit it. I'll give it a name. I'll select a server. For the entity, you need to select an entity which will act as a trigger. Let's say I'll add a motion sensor as a trigger. Now you can check the state based on your entity type. If your entity is a sensor with analog value, you can select a number. If it has multiple states, you can select string to check if your required state is active. For this example, since this is a binary sensor, that means it has only two states, on or off. So I'll simply select either the boolean to use true or false states. Now for action, you need to drag another node onto the flow. So for this one, I'll drag call service node and double click on this one to edit it. I'll give it a name. Then I'll select a server again, which will be the home assistant, and then select the domain. Now for domain, as you might know, since you are using home assistant, that domain is a unique identifier of specific integration or specific types of entities. Let's say if you have lights to control, then you select the domain light. For aircon, you'll select climate and so on. As you keep adding more integration, you'll keep seeing new options under domains based on what integration you have added to your home assistant. In our case, since we are trying to control light, so I'll select the domain light. Then I'll select a service, which of course will be turned on because we are trying to turn on the light based on the motion. Then you need to select at least one of these three options based on what you have or what you are trying to do. I'll select the entity and add the entity name in there. There are additional properties for data which are optional, and you can test these out if your light supports them by clicking on load example data. This will populate the data field, and I'll skip this for you to explore and test. Now, next step is we need to wire both the nodes we just created. To do that, click on the connection terminal for true state on this state chain node, and then drag the connection wiring towards the call service node. Now, the last step is to deploy the code. So if we click on the drop down arrow on the deploy button, you will see three main options. The first one is full. This will deploy all the flows. The second one is modified flows. This will deploy only the flows which are modified and were not deployed previously. The third one is modified nodes. This will deploy only the nodes which were modified. I like to deploy only the nodes which I just modified and generally avoid unnecessary deployment to the flows. So I'll select the third option, which is deploy only modified nodes. And I deploy the node. Now I need to trigger the motion sensor to test my automation and verify the light does turn on. I can also test this automation by setting the state of motion sensor from developer tools. Under developer tools, if I set the motion sensor state to on, this should switch the light on. So I'll go to developers tool, click on state, and then click on set state. And here I can set the state which I want, and this should trigger the automation. Let's go back to the Node-RED to verify this. Okay, now we can see the automation is triggered. There is a timestamp under both nodes. At what time did they trigger? And also, we can see the light did turn on the dashboard. Alright, so this is your first and simple automation on Node-RED. You can create a lot more using the community add-on nodes. To add more nodes into your Node-RED installation, click on the hamburger menu on the top right corner and then go to manage palettes. The left tab with the name node is the list of already added nodes. Now select the install tab on the right side and search for the node you want to add. Let's say I need to install a node for Google Maps. I'll search for maps and then I will install a node called Google Maps. Once the install is complete, you can simply search the node from the search bar on the left side of the menu on top of the nodes. And there you can see the Google Map node, which is ready for you to drag into the flow and start using it. If you want to remove any installed nodes, you can do so by simply going back to the Manage Palettes, search it under Nodes, and then remove or disable it from there. I have been using Node-RED extensively in my home system installation, and I find it very powerful and very easy to use. I have been using it for my entry and exit sequence, for my critical notifications. Also, I have integrated my calendar into it using the calendar nodes to announce upcoming events and appointments on Google and Apple speakers. I have added my Roborock vacuum cleaner automation then sequence using the Node-RED as well. So this is my main automation handling add-on in Home Assistant. I hardly use the Home Assistant built-in automations. Anyway, this was just to show you how Node-RED is installed and just the basic introduction of Node-RED. Of course, this does not justify the power of Node-RED. The whole point of this video was just to introduce Node-RED. To me, Node-RED is as powerful as your imagination. So from here onwards, I'll leave it to you to explore and come up with more ideas. Let me know down in the comments below if you like Node-RED or you still prefer to stick your home assistant automations. Alright, that's it for this video. Please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. I'll see you in the next video.